Hello, this is Nancy of Yoga Journeys, and for today's journey, we are going to go through the five Tibetan rites. We're going to use these as a sort of warm-up. We often use sun, in vinyasa practices, we often use the sun salutation to warm up the body to get us ready to go into deeper poses. But for today, we'll give you a little bit of an alternative. It's known as the five Tibetan rites. Now, the history of the five Tibetan rites is questionable. It got introduced to the West in about the 1930s, late 1930s, by a guy who was very interested in spiritualism and claimed that he met a colonel, an army colonel in Tibet, or who had come back from Tibet and received these five ancient practices that are supposed to be the fountain of youth. it's supposed to reduce gray hair. It's supposed to definitely increase mobility, which that one it does. I can't attest to the gray hair part. So let's go ahead and move right into them. They're typically associated with the five elements if you're interested in that symbolism. I'll detail that on my blog. It's connected, Yoga Journey 108. But for those just interested in the exercise, we'll go ahead and start. It's typically done in groups of seven, building up from seven to eventually 21. So we're going to be doing seven of each. And the first one is very simple and fun. So let's come into beginner's mind for this one. Very simple. Arms come out to a T, palms face downward. Now we're going to go clockwise. Okay, what is clockwise? That means the left hand comes around the front first. That was one. Two. Right. Exhale, forward fold.
our downward dog.
Okay, so for this one, we're moving from down dog to up dog, but we're not gonna release onto the tops of our feet. The traditional up dog hands us on the tops of our feet, right? Squeezing our shoulder blades back. But for this one, we're gonna stay on our toes. So as we come into our modified downward dog. Now because you're suspended higher, it's very important to keep the core engaged to protect the lower back. Okay? We don't want to be sagging into that upward dog pose. So the downward dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. This is our exhale. Inhale, we're going to come forward through plank, drop the pelvis toward the mat, chest comes through the arms, squeeze the shoulder blades together. Where's your core? Back to down dog, that's one. If you like the video, hit like, and if you'd like to see more, please hit subscribe. Thanks so much for watching. Namaste.